At the same time, we have a problem of drug consumption. Does the United States have a co-responsibility for what's going on in Mexico?
No. The United States doesn't have a responsibility for what's going on in Mexico. I think if anybody has responsibility in the government, it was this failed operation by the Justice Department where a lot of guns got put
Fast and Furious.
Fast and Furious, where a lot of guns got put into Mexico, and there's congressional investigations of that right now, which I think are going to go all the way up to the Attorney General of the United States. Look, there is a huge violence problem in Mexico. What's happening in Mexico is what happened in Colombia. You know, in the 90s and the 2000s, Colombia was plagued by the FARC, which was a terrorist group, not just a drug runner, but terrorists. And now you're seeing that happen in Mexico. And a lot of it is because Colombia stabilized. Now Mexico is devolving. And you're seeing these terrorist groups, they're not just drug gangs. They are decapitating people. I think there was a story this morning about decapitated heads in Mexico City. They hang bodies from lampposts to scare people from reporting against these drug members and members of these cartels. It's very, very dangerous. And I talked to President Fox about it when I was in the United States Senate. And I commended him to follow what President Uribe did in Colombia, which is to take this on not as a law enforcement action, to take it on as a military action. That's why Colombia was so successful. They fought it like it was a war, not like it was law enforcement. We've got to be careful and pay attention to what's happening in Mexico, because it is destabilizing. And I think what we can do, and what we are doing, is lending our military help to the Mexican government so that they can fight against these cartels and drug dealers.